So about 4 weeks ago, I got 3 new fish from Petco. One of them was a baby Julie Cory, and the other two were 2 yellow guppies. I already had 4 Cory cat fish in my tank, but 3 of them were Agzazi Corys. I might have pronounced that wrong. And the 4th one was a Julie Cory. So since they were different species, the 3 Agzazi Corys never hung out with the Julie Cory, so he was always alone. So that's why I decided to get him a little buddy. Now they're swimming around together all the time, and it's so cute. I absolutely adore it. The 2 yellow guppies, however, ended up jumping out of the tank. After the guppies jumped out, I started noticing that the other fish were acting weird, like something was annoying them, bothering them. They were trying to get something off them. They were splashing around the top, rubbing up against leaves. So one of those days, I took a closer look at my fish, and when I looked at the neon tetras, I noticed they were covered in white spots, so I knew straight away that it was ick. I never thought I'd have to deal with ick, but my time has come. So I ordered online an adjustable heater, because the heaters I have are preheat heaters. So I got an adjustable one, and along with a few other things. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you that unboxing real quick. First thing I have here is some Prime water conditioner. Next thing I got was this thermometer to keep track of the temperature in my tank. I also got some Flourish root tabs because I'm all out. And I got my dog some more toothpaste. And finally, this is the heater that will hopefully work and kill all the ick. So that heater did end up working, just not properly. So basically I had to put my preheat heater and that heater in my tank just to get it up to 85 degrees, which is the highest temperature neon tetras can handle. So by cranking up the heater to 93 degrees and having the other heater in there as well, it got just under 85 degrees on the thermometer. So I also put a different air wand in the tank, one that creates larger bubbles and more of them, so that it would hopefully break the surface a lot more to put in more oxygen in the water, since warm water holds less oxygen. After a few days, I noticed that there wasn't any more white spots on the neon tetras. The fish weren't being bothered anymore, so the heater was definitely doing its job. There are other treatments or ways to get rid of ick, but I chose the heat treatment because it was the cheapest for me, and I thought it would be the more or less stressful option for the fish. So it's now been 2 weeks since I started the treatment, and all the fish are still alive and well. The ick seems to be completely gone. I'm still gonna keep the heater on for another week just to make sure that all the ick is dead. I also got some new guppies recently, which will be in the next video, you'll see. The guppies have been in a separate quarantine tank for about a week now, and so have the new betas I got. Oh, I also forgot to mention that one of my platies, my oldest platy in the community tank, I had to take him out of the tank after seeing the ick. I took him out, put him in his own tank, so he's been living in there this whole time. He's still not dead, I'm quite surprised. Anyway, the platy looked the worst. He didn't appear to have ick, but there was other things wrong with him. He's an old fish. And yeah, I'm not sure what he has, but he's gonna live the rest of his days in that quarantine tank. He was a bully to the other platy in the tank, so it's good that he's not going back in there. That other platy is finally swimming in peace. Literally. Not dead, but actually swimming in the tank without a bully. So if you ever encounter ick, I recommend the heat treatment. Medications work as well. My guess is that the ick came in the tank from the new fish I got, or just something happened somehow. But it's gone now, so